If there were such things as mermaids, sunken treasure, and romance on the high seas, you might have the makings for an animated Disney movie. Or you just might have the real-life adventure of Dolores Fisher. Dolores, or Deo as she was known to her friends, held the world's underwater endurance record for women, spearfished with the best, and raised a family of aquanauts. No small feat when you're trying to share the dream of the man who would be known as the world's greatest treasure hunter. He did promise her fun, romance, and adventure, if that's what she wanted. Mel Fisher may not have realized it at first, but he was soon to learn that the beautiful redhead he was taking on this journey would be the only person that could make his dream a reality. And she did this all without fanfare and behind the scenes. And as always, expressing their goals as Mel's master plan.
He was a pioneer in the diving industry. The reason that he got into so many things was because he wanted to go through all of the different aspects of diving that he could.
Even if one of those aspects meant searching for 16 years for the elusive Atocha.
And we looked and looked and looked and could not believe it wasn't there.
There are so many things that have tried to defeat us that you have to be strong together and just take each problem as it comes and overcome it. I think if we had, you know, given up on the project someplace along the way, that we would have been defeated the rest of our lives. We were always on a trail, and trails just kept providing us with a little bit here and a little bit there, and just saying, come on, come on, you know, keep going. It's something that it was just kind of like a tease. I'm out here, you can find me.
If it was a tease for Deo, it was nearly debilitating for the crew. But it was her comforting words of encouragement that kept us all going until that one day on July 20th, 1985, when we walked into the office.
And every report that came in over the radio, it got death quiet in there, and everybody just stopped to listen to every word they said.
There's lobsters around it the whole bit.
And when the radio transmission would end, everybody would start cheering again and pouring more champagne.
Although millions of people all over the world have watched Mel Fisher pick up the radio and talk to his son Kane on the rec site, few have seen or heard Deo's first words to her son, who had just realized all their dreams.
CT 9605, Unit 11, this is Unit 1.
This is Mama. How
are
you doing today, Mama?
Hey, I've been hearing some wild rumors in here. I want to hear it straight from the horse's mouth.
Yeah, we got it finally. Yep.
That's better. What do you got,
Kane? A letter, the mother letter. Mother letter in search.
Does that mean the mother maybe ought to come out there and sit on it?
Yeah, come on out.
Get him to tell what it looks like and everything. What does it look like, Kane?
It looks like a reef.
Yeah, I think.
And there's
silver bars all over the place.
Not big,
millions of coins.
Hey, have you got your t-shirt that says it's in the mud?
Yeah, I don't know where it is.
It's probably in the mud, huh?
Yeah, it might be.
Ask them what they're doing right now.
What are you guys doing right now?
We're dusting it off with a swordfish, and then we're gonna get in and haul up a few of them.
Oh, that sounds real good. I'm glad to hear you guys are doing your good housekeeping and doing the dusting.
Glad to hear that, yeah.
After the mother load, Deo Fisher arranges a party for Mel's 63rd birthday. And on it went for the next 24 years. Deo Fisher, working behind the scenes, arranging, helping, encouraging people with her infinite compassion and never-ending love.
birthday present, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, don't expect this every year.
In January of 2009, after being diagnosed with terminal cancer, she left the hospital and returned to her home in Montana, where she was surrounded by family.
Yes, it was Silver Banks, and the water was warm and clear, and this beautiful tropical fish swimming all around, and she found this giant red sponge. And it was the kind of sponge, I forget what they called it. Basket sponge. And she went down and sat inside the sponge, and Dad was taking pictures of her sitting in the sponge with her hair flowing out. She looked like a mermaid.
Queen of the mermaids.
Yeah, and she really enjoyed that spot. So she talks about it a lot.
She keeps reliving it in her mind. That's a beautiful place to be.
One of her very happy spots.
Wonderful. That's great. Well, it's good to have her home.
Yeah, it is.
That's the time we leave at 7. I'll be waiting up for heaven, counting every mile of railroad track that takes me back. Never thought my heart could be so yearning. Gotta take that sentimental journey, sentimental.